Hey folks, Will with MinIO here with a how-to, and today we're going to be listing objects in MinIO using JavaScript. We're going to be using Node v18, and we're going to be connecting to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox for MinIO users, and we're going to be doing all of this out of Visual Studio Code. Let's take a look. Okay, those of you who have seen a few of these how-tos so far may be looking at this code going, wow, this is more complicated than before. In point of fact, it's not really more complicated. We just have more versions of how you can do a list objects. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to take you through the three different ways you can do this, talk about some of the differences, and then we're going to show you how you can hit this up. But as usual, we are just getting a connection to play.min.io through our MinIO demo functions toolset. And what we're going to do is we are going to list objects. This is the original. And the original list objects takes a bucket, a prefix, which is optional, recursive, true or false, which is also optional. It also allows you to hand in some additional options. And in this case, I'm asking it to include the version in my result list. Now, this is something that list objects v2 and list objects v2 with metadata do not do and do not have support for. So if I need to include some specific fields, some specific information, I'm going to want to use the list objects. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab all of the objects, I'm going to put them in this data array, and then I'm going to print that data array out. You're going to see it's going to be the same object over and over and over, but they're going to have different versions. My second example here is on list objects v2, and like list objects, it takes a bucket name, a prefix, an optional recursion flag, but it also has this wonderful start after optional item, which basically says the object name to start after when we're listing the objects. So if I don't want to get all of the objects, if I have a particular object name, I just want to get everything after that, I can list it that way. Now, what I'm seeing here, or what I'm going to get out of this, is the same sort of information as I got out of list objects. The fact that I have an object, it's going to be called mdf.js. But why would I use list objects v2 over list objects? And the answer for this is list objects v2 is actually better performing on the server side than list objects. And this is due in large part because MinIO likes to keep parity with all of the S3 APIs, and actually AWS S3 also included a list objects v2 method in their API. So we want to make sure that we are keeping up with S3. We want to make sure that we are implementing all of the S3 features in parity with S3. And so that's why we have this list objects v2. We also have a list objects v2 with metadata, same arguments, same result, but now I can get the metadata back. And you're going to see that the metadata, in fact, does not include version information. But let's go ahead and run this, and I'll show you what we're going to get out of all of this. If I run this with node index.js, here's what I get out. So here's the v2 with metadata. So this is, I'll roll backwards through this. Notice that the difference between the v2 and the v2 with metadata is really this additional metadata field. And in this case, one of the pieces that I do have in my metadata is this content type application JavaScript. That's a piece of metadata that I added when I uploaded this particular file to MinIO. And if you want to see that, that was done in a previous how-to. So that's the difference between v2 and v2 with metadata. The difference that I've also included here for list objects is the fact that I am now including things like the version ID. And I also get a little more information back out of this. Now, do I need all of this information? If not, use v2. It's faster, it's more performant. But if I need to get some specific information, like for instance, the version ID, which allows me to get all of the versions of this mds.js that is existing on my MinIO server now, then I can use list objects. So that covers kind of the differences between list objects, list objects v2, list objects v2 with metadata. I hope you've enjoyed this particular how-to. If you would like to contact us, by all means, reach out to us on any of the methods that you see on the screen here. You can also Slack us on minio.slack.com. And if you just want to leave a comment on this video, we will always take a look at them and respond. Thanks very much, and we'll see you in the next video.